Hello guys, in today's video I'll show you how to log in to your FreeNAS using SSH or secure shell. So probably this is the most common question I have right now, like people wasn't able to log in SSH or when they log in they encounter issues. So this is the reason why I decided to make the video. Hopefully it gonna help you out. So I am trying to replicate like all the issue that you have. So this is the most common one. Once you log in, you can open up like a command prompt if you're on Windows, and terminal if you're on Mac or Unix or Linux. All right, a lot of time I log in using my domain name FQDN or fully qualified domain name. If you have a DNS at home, then yes, you can do that. If you don't, use the IP address that listed on the FreeNAS network info. That should work the same, but whether you're on Windows or Mac OS, it should be the same. The command at SSH stand for secure shell, and username, and in this tutorial I'll use the root username basically, because most of you are going to use root user anyway, even though it's not recommended to. And by the way, I recommend that you using just a standard users, but aside a standard user to the wheel root, or it the equivalent of the administrator root in the window. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, then watch my tutorial on FreeNAS user account management. I'm gonna talk more about the differences between a system account and a user account, but for this tutorial I'm just gonna talk about secure shell. And like I said, if you have a domain name, then you can use your domain fully qualified domain name in here with your subdomain. And if you don't, you can use the IP address. It should work the same way. I'll show you a both way. So when you do that, it's gonna say connection refill. This is number one reason people keep asking me, hey, why it's not working. Or you do with your IP address 192.168.41.4202, and same thing, you get a connection refills. So if you get a connection refill, why? I'll tell you the reason why. That's because SSH services is not enabled in the FreeNAS. So from the FreeNAS, you navigate out to services and turn on your SSH right here. Bam, it's on. All right. So now I'm gonna show you another one that people encounter a lot. Alright, so now it asks you the authenticity of the domain. If you say yes, then it's good. If you and now it's gonna ask you for a password, you're gonna type in the password and you're gonna say permission deny. Let me enter a couple times. All right, let's try with the IP address. All right, and still it said permission deny, and I'll tell you why right now. So if I log in with the root users via SSH, by default, because they're not recommended to, so you have to go to the advanced option in SSH or configuration and changes to allow root login from remote login. If not, I have a standard user and it will let me log in with the standard users. Oops. Oh, that's right. then I'm in, but I'm not a root user. But if I want to perform a task as a root user, I can only use the su command. They're gonna ask me for the root password. And now I'm root instead of logging in straight and using a root username. And let me show you why is it that when you log into using a root user and it say permission deny. Alright, edit action, you hit on the action config. It say right here log in as a root with passwords. By default it's not enabled. That is why you get a permission deny. If you willing to take the risk and you want to log in with your root user, then you're gonna enable that one. You see right here, root login added courage. You should disable it by default. If you want to log in using your root, you have to enable it and save it. And let's try it again. Interesting. Why still say permission deny? Oh shoot. Let's see. Oh, it probably I probably have to close out a command prompt and try it again. It probably still remembered the last section. Alright, let's open up the new command prompt. And let me edit H root at 192.168.1.202 and password. Enter, and there you go. You no longer have the permission deny. So this is the reason why that you get a permission denies. But once again, I'm not recommended doing this way. You should disable the login with root password. And it's not like every day you have to log in via the secure shell to manage your system. It's only when it have issue or the initial setup, or every time you need to set up jail remotely or whatever. So by default, every time you're done with the task, you should turn up the edit edge and do not start automatically. Cause by keeping the connection open, basically you expose yourself to attack or whatnot. If your FreeNAS is not behind a firewall and it's not secure, or you expose your FreeNAS to the internet, which is not recommended to, you should just have a log in with the regular user, like I showed you earlier. Edit H and then my regular users at 192.168.1.4202. It annoys that you have to do the su command and enter the root password one more time, but for security, that adds an extra layer for security. And just for your information, if you any task perform as a root user, it will not be locked in the system file. Any task that using the su command, it will be locked in the system file. And now you are root users. And that's it for this tutorial, guys. I hope that you find it helpful, and hopefully it's gonna help some of you out that having the issue connection refuse or permission deny. And If you think the video is helpful, don't forget to thumb up and subscribe to my channel for more tutorial. And I'll see you guys in the next video.